Welcome, dear student, in my channel. I will deal with this zoology paper. Basically, the first year and second year zoology. Now, in the first year zoology subject, I will deal with the animal diversity first paper. So, we'll discuss today the different topics which include in the paper animal diversity first. But before going to deal in the different topics, first of all we'll see the marking system for first year. Now this is our paper first, animal diversity first, for the first term. It is of for 2 credit and there are the 30 lectures and the marks are internal plus university, which are internals are 15 and university exam, that is theory, which is of 35 marks and total is of 50 marks, and you will have to score the minimum from 15, you will have to just score minimum 6 marks, and from university theory exam you will have to score out of 35 minimum 14 marks, and total out of 50 you should generally have the 20 marks. So this is marking pattern. This is not only for this subject but also all the remaining subjects and the paper you opted for the first year. This is about the choice based credit system pattern. Now after this marking pattern or the system, we will move towards the different topics which comes under the animal diversity first. So in animal diversity first, we will have to study the 7 different topics. Of these 7 different topics, the first topic is principles of classification, that is taxonomy and systematics. Basically, this animal diversity first paper, which deals with the systematic arrangement and the classification of animals on the basis of their characters, structures, that is morphological, anatomical, physiological, embryological characters, and all these systematic arrangements done under this taxonomy, which deals with the classification of living organism. In this first topic, the first subject is taxonomy, and in a taxonomy we'll have to study the basic terminology and introduction. What are the different terms which comes under this terminology and help for classification, and which again include the alpha, beta and gamma levels of taxonomy: micro taxonomy, macro taxonomy, phenetics, which includes the numerical taxonomy, then cladistic, then phylogenetic systematics, evolutionary taxonomy or evolutionary systematics. Then it also includes classical taxonomy and experimental or neo taxonomy, which is nothing but the biochemical taxonomy and cytotaxonomy. Then in the taxonomy or this last bit is significance of taxonomy. So this is the first subbit in the principles of classification. Second subbit is the systematics, its definition and introduction. Third subbit is the Linnaean system of classification, which include 6 level of classification. And what is about the 6 level? Phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Hope you all are familiar with this classification, and I think you have done in 11th or 12th. And the fourth sub-BT is concept of species, which include the biological and evolutionary. Then introduction to binomial nomenclature, that is two naming system. Then introduction, the last sub-BT, sixth sub-BT is the introduction to five kingdom system. These five kingdoms are kingdom Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animali. So this is about the five kingdom system. Now after this first bit or the first topic, the second topic is general features of kingdom Animalia. And this second topic, which include the general characters of kingdom Animalia along with the grades of organization, and the second bit deals with the symmetry. So this is second topic. The third topic deals with the kingdom Protista, which is also called as phylum Protozoa. This kingdom Protista includes the different topics. Number first is introduction to phylum Protozoa. Then second one, salient features of phylum Protozoa. Then third one, classification of phylum Protozoa up to classes with two examples of each class, and only the names are to be required. And the class that we are going to study, the number first class is class Rhizopoda, and the examples are Entamoeba histolytica and Arcella. Then the second class is class Mastigophora, which includes the Euglena viridis and Trypanosoma gambiens. Class 3, which include the class Ciliata, and examples are Paramecium caudatum and Opalina ranarum. And the fourth class that we are going to deal under this third subbit is class Sporozoa, which includes the Plasmodium vivax and Taxoplasma gondii. So these are the classes with example. And the fourth bit from this third topic is locomotion in Protozoa, and the different types of the locomotion that we are going to study are amoeboid locomotion, ciliary and flagellar locomotion with suitable examples. Then fifth bit from this third topic is the type study, and we will have to study the animal, protozoan animal, Paramecium caudatum in detail, its classification, habit and habitat, external morphology, feeding and digestion, excretion along with the reproduction, and asexual as well as sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, that is binary fission, and sexual reproduction, that is conjugation. So these are the bits that we are going to deal under the fifth bit of the third topic. Now the sixth sub bit or the subtopic are economic importance of Protozoa, and we'll have to study three harmful and one useful protozoan. And the harmful protozoans are Plasmodium vivax, which causes the malaria and called as a malarial parasite. The second harmful protozoans are Entamoeba histolytica, which causing the amoebic dysentery. Third parasitic protozoan or harmful protozoan is Trypanosoma gambiens, causing the gambiens sleeping sickness. So these are the parasitic or harmful protozoan that we have to study under this sixth bit. And the last bit from this third topic is useful protozoan, and we'll have to study the Trichonympha. These are the only representative examples. There are so many harmful and useful protozoans, but these are the representative examples that we are going to study from this third topic. Now, the next topic, that is fourth one, is origin of metazoa, and the origin of metazoa, which includes the introduction, origin and importance of metazoa, that is the multicellular animal. Protozoan that we have studied is unicellular one. Now this is the next group which arises, that is metazoans or multicellular animal. These we are going to deal in the fourth topic. After this fourth, the fifth topic is the phylum Porifera. In the phylum Porifera, we have to study the introduction to phylum Porifera in the first bit. The second bit is of classification of phylum Porifera up to classes, with two examples of each class. Again, in this, only the names are to be required. No description of specimen is required. Then this classification, we'll have to study the three different classes. Number first class is Calcarea. Examples are Leucosolenia and Cycon. Or Cycon is also called as Scypha. Then the second class is Exactinida. Example is Euplectella, that is Venus flower basket. And the second example is Hylonema, which is also called as glass sponge. Then the third class in the Porifera is Demospongia, and the examples are Chalina, which is called as the mermaid's glues. The second example is Spongilla, which is called as the freshwater sponge. So these are the three different classes from phylum Porifera. The next bit is canal system in sponges. Basically, this is feeding system in sponges, and we will have to study the different types of feeding habits. As Poriferans are to be grows from simple to complex one, and the systems are Ascon type of canal system, Leucon type of canal system, and Ragon type of canal system. There is another type of canal system, that is Cycon type of canal system, is also present. And in last bit, we have to study the skeleton in sponges, which include the spicules, its types. There are these microscleres and megascleres, and again monoexon, which includes the monoactinal, diactinal, amphyrix, triaxon, polyaxon, spongin fibers. So these are the types of spicules we are going to study under the skeleton in sponges. Then the fifth bit includes the regeneration in sponges. The wounded or ruptures or broken part of the body is going to be reappear, that is called as a regeneration. Then last bit is economic importance of phylum Porifera. So this is about the fifth topic, phylum Porifera. Now after this fifth one, the sixth topic is the phylum Cnidaria, or it is also called as Cylindrata, in which we will discuss the five different bits, which are: the number first is introduction to phylum Cnidaria. Then the second one is salient features of phylum Cnidaria. Third one, is classification of phylum Cnidaria up to classes with given examples, and each class again here names of examples only names are to be expected, and class Hydrozoa, example Hydra, Physalia is also called as Portuguese man of war, class Kyphozoa, example Arulia or jellyfish, and Lucernaria, which is also called as trumpet shaped jellyfish, and the last class, that is Anthozoa, and the examples are Metridium. It is also called as the sea animal. Then the fourth bit is polymorphism in Hydrozoa. In polymorphism, we have to study the polyps and medusa. In polyps, we have to study the types, gastrozoite, ductylozoites, and gonozoites, and the functions of these polyps. Then the last bit in the phylum Cnidaria or Coelenterata is economic importance of Cnidarians with reference to corals and coral reef. So this is the sixth bit in the phylum Cnidaria. This is the fifth bit in the phylum Cnidaria. Then the last topic is phylum Platyhelminths. These Platyhelminths includes again the five different subbits, which are introduction to phylum Platyhelminths, salient features of phylum Platyhelminths, then the third bit is classification of phylum Platyhelminths up to classes with two examples each class. Here also only the names are expected. The first class is Turbellaria, examples are Dewgesia and Bipalium. The second class is Trematoda, and the examples are Fasciola hepatica and Schistosoma hematobium. Class third is Cystoda, Tenia solium, which is commonly called as a pork tapeworm, and Echinococcus granulosus, which is commonly called as dog tapeworm. So this is about the classification. Third bit, fourth bit in the phylum Platyhelminths is parasitic adaptations in Platyhelminths and structural and physiological adaptations we are going to study in the Platyhelminths. And the last bit in the phylum Platyhelminths is economic importance of Platyhelminths. So this is all about the syllabus we have for the first semester in animal diversity first in the subject zoology for first year BSc course. Hope you all understand all these seven different topics. Still, if you have any doubt or the queries regarding the topics or the different terms, please write into the comment box. So I will try to answer all these your queries. Thank you very much.